You want to train your students for competitive exams like NEET, UPSC, GATE or IIT. You have prepared hundreds of questions in various formats like MCQs, numeric and essays. You want to create multiple mock question drills for your students and also want to evaluate how much they have scored in each test. You can do all these and much more with the new Learnyst Online Exam Creator feature. Welcome to another video on Learnyst product tutorials. And in this video, we will specifically talk about creating an online quiz using a very simple Excel template. You can upload hundreds of questions using this technique. Let us begin. So here I have a huge list of questions to prepare my students for the competitive exam. Let us see how to upload them into a mock test using Excel. To create a mock test, first, let us go to your admin dashboard. Click on products and select the mock tests. For our mock test creation, let's go ahead and click on the green color create button on the top right corner. Now, let us give a proper test title, price, and hit the create button. Here, you will be prompted to select a quiz template. Let me quickly explain what these templates are. The general template is what you can select by default. Here, when students finish answering all the questions, they will view the answers after the test. Next comes the practice quiz. The practice quiz is slightly different. Here, students will view the answers after they finish every question. So, use this practice option only if you give practice test for your students. If you want specific templates for competitive exams like CAT, UPSC, IIT, SSC and so on, you can go ahead and pick those templates. We constantly update this template as per the actual exam. So by choosing competitive exam templates, you can provide your students with an exact replica of the actual competitive exams. For the time being, let us select the general exam template and click on the create button. Here you will be taken to the test builder. As you can see, the general template has already created the first section. Towards the left bottom, you will see the option import from pool and import. Let us click on import. Here you will get two template options. You can either select the Word template or you can select the Excel template to upload your questions. Let us select the Excel import option and click on next. Now, click on the question import template in step number 1 to download the Excel template. This downloads the question import template. Let us go ahead and open this Excel template. The process of entering data in this Excel template is really straightforward. On the first row, you will have headers that represent the system tags. So these tags tell the system whether the data you enter in the second row is a section or a question or a mark and so on. To add a section name, enter the name you would like for the test section within the section name field, which is in column B. Using these values, the system will create multiple sections named section 1, section 2 and group the questions within the respective section. Column C is named tags. Here you can enter question tags based on the topic that they belong to. For example, geometry, Q&A and so on. Every question within a section will have positive and negative marks. You can enter those values within the column D and E. Apart from marks, you can add more details to your questions like the difficulty level, answer time, and so on. If a question has instructions, you can paste the instructions in column H. Note that tag, difficulty, answer time, solution, and instruction tags are completely optional and can be left blank. To add a question, all you have to do is to scroll to your right side and go to column J, which is the question. The template already has some sample questions written in it to give you a rough idea. You can simply copy and paste your questions into that cell. The solution to every question can be pasted in the answer explanation column, which is column I. As you know, you can create four types of questions, namely multiple choice, numeric, essay, and fill in the blanks. For each of these four question types, it's important that you enter the exact four question type values. So for instance, if you want to create multiple choice questions, you have to enter multi underscore choice in column K, which is the question type column, and you shouldn't be entering anything else. Same way for numeric, the question type value should be numeric itself. For an essay question, the value should be an essay, and for fill in the blank question type, the value should be fill underscore in underscore the underscore blanks. Please make sure that you use the exact same values as it is within the question type. The columns after the question type allow you to enter answer options. So for example, if you are creating an MCQ question with four options, you can enter the values of the four options in option 1, option 2, option 3 and option 4 columns. By default, the system will give you 5 answer options. So if your MCQ has only 4 options, you can leave the option 5 column blank. Out of these 4 options, if option number 2 is correct, then enter 2 within the correct options column, which is column number L. Now if more than one option is correct in your MCQ question, like for example option number 1 and 4, you can enter 1,4 within column number L. Please remember that the columns M, N, O, P and Q are relevant only for the MCQ questions. For numeric and fill in the blanks question types, you have to enter the correct value in column L. Lastly, we have the essay question. As you know, the essay questions will have evaluation criteria to provide a guideline for the evaluators. So in essay type questions, you will find the evaluation criteria and percentage tags for your essay question. You will find 5 default criteria tags in this template. Feel free to add criteria for your essay questions under these 5 columns or leave them blank as per your need. The row 10 onwards are just legends mentioned for instruction purposes. Feel free to remove them from the template. With this, we have summed up the key elements of this Excel template. Now let us see how this works with an example. Let us say we need to upload a quiz with 3 sections. In this example, section 1 will have MCQ questions, section 2 will have a mix of fill in the blanks and numeric questions, and section 3 with few essay questions. In the interest of time, I have prepared this Excel import document for you, and I will quickly show you how it looks. As you can see, I have created 3 sections, namely section 1 MCQ, section 2 numeric and fill in the blanks, and section 3 essay. I have also entered the positive and negative marks for each question, along with other details like question tags, levels, and instructions. One advantage of using this Excel template is that you can easily copy and paste the questions and enter the values in the respective columns very easily. For example, I have inserted math equations in the question column as shown in question number 1. All I had to do was paste the math equation in LaTeX form. If you are not sure how to do that, do watch our video on how to insert math equations for your quiz. I have also used all the question type values exactly as it is and also mentioned the answer options. A slight disadvantage of this Excel template is that it doesn't allow you to add any images to your question. So if you are someone who wants to create image based questions, then I suggest you to add them separately on the test builder after uploading the questions using this template. Alternatively, you can use the Word import template to upload questions and use it to upload images. After making all the necessary changes, save the Excel file with a proper file name and .xlsx extension. Now that we have readied this template, let us go ahead and upload the template. let us go back to the Import Questions option and click on the Upload file. Select the Excel file and upload it. If the formatting is proper, the system will show it as Upload Success. Now click on Next. After this, you can review your uploaded question. Once you're satisfied, click on the Publish to import all the questions to the Question Builder. As you can see, we have created three sections. One for MCQ questions, numeric, and essay questions using the Excel input. The system has successfully uploaded the MCQs and marked the right answers and the solution explanations. This looks really good to be published right now. If you still want to change your test questions, it is possible to do that in the Test Builder. For example, to change the answer option of question number 1, click on the question and change to an alternate option. Once you have done that, click on Save. If you prefer to add images in the questions, options, or answer explanations, you can do so in the Test Builder. Once you are satisfied with the changes, you can make this test accessible to your learners. To do that, let us go ahead and publish the test. Before publishing the test, you can consider to configure your test as per your requirement. For example, if you want to schedule this test, like give it a start and end time, you can do that by selecting the scheduling checkbox. Click on the start time calendar, select a date, and select a time. Same way, click on the end time calendar and select a date and select a time. You can even select the enabled result schedule option to publish the results at a specified date and specified time. There are many configurations that you can set for your tests. You can find these configurations in the Quiz Features tab. Like for example, the overall quiz time, section order selection, leaderboards, question randomizations, and many more. I suggest you go through all the available options before publishing your test. Now, click on the Publish button to make your tests live. Congratulations! You have successfully created an online quiz using the Excel template. Let me quickly show you how the test will appear to your students. Here, I have logged in as a student to take the test. Let me go ahead and select the mock test. Now, let me go ahead and click on the Take Test. As a student, I will be able to see your questions, images, mathematical equations, and also be able to submit the answers. Lastly, I can even get the performance scores after the test. Since accessing and viewing student performance is beyond the scope of this video, I will try to cover it in a different video in the future. So with this, we have come to the end of this video. Now let us recap the key points in this video. First, we saw how to create a mock test and download the Excel question import template. We then learned how to use various tags in the template to create sections, add questions and answers. We then uploaded the template, created sections and added questions in our mock test. We also learned to schedule a mock test and also saw various test configurations you can try, like retake attempts, test duration and so on. And finally, we saw how students will take the test and submit the answers. I hope this video helped you to know how to import multiple questions in your online test. Hope you will be able to upload questions in bulk and save tons of time by using the Excel template. Let me know in the comment section below which tools you use to create your mock test or what challenges you face while uploading your questions. And as always, if you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Do hit the bell icon to get instant notifications on course creation and course marketing tips. So until next time, see you, take care and bye bye.